Where's Truffle?
On an orchard in rural Virginia, 13-year-old red-bone coonhound Nadine keeps her nose to the ground.
Where is it? Come on.
Weaving around English oaks in search of a rare and expensive crop, one that's rarely even found growing in the United States.
Wow.
The black Perigord truffle.
She's getting a little older, but she loves her job.
It only took a few weeks for the family who runs Virginia Truffles to train her for this crucial job on the farm. Vanessa Shea helps handle Nadine and the other dogs who work on this truffle orchard. Shea's parents, Pat and John Martin, planted the truffle inoculated trees in 2008.
John was getting ready to retire, and he thought, wouldn't it be cool if we did something fun, something that used his chemistry science? It became an adventure.
The Martins also saw an opportunity in the growing demand for truffles. Unlike typical commodity crops like wheat or soy, truffles take a long time to grow. Pat Martin says it took nearly a decade to know if the symbiotic relationship between truffle and tree was working.
We got our first harvest in 2018. It was very exciting. It was like having the first baby. Break out the champagne.
Black Perigord truffles can go for a retail price of up to $1,200 a pound during peak market times. They're so expensive because they're so scarce and prized for their delicate aroma and taste.
Truffles are ephemeral in their experience. They're as much aroma as they are flavor.
Margaret Townsend is head of the North American Truffle Growers Association. Townsend says her group wants to educate both consumers and growers to supply American-grown truffles for a growing demand. It's a trendy item for people looking for a little luxury in the mundane.
We are an underserved market. You go into restaurants and you get truffle oil, truffle fries, truffle baked potato.
Black truffles were traditionally foraged in southern Europe, but wild truffle habitat has declined due to deforestation, among other reasons. The Martin's Orchard is one of an expanding industry of farm-grown truffles in America, following in the footsteps of Spain and Australia.
The industry is very new in the U.S. We've got some farms going here in Virginia. Nobody is very big.
There's a lack of research on how to best grow truffles in America. For example, what type of soil to use or which trees to plant.
We are giving really good information to new growers coming on board because we want them to help us establish the industry in the U.S.
American-grown truffles, just like this one, are starting to hit the market in a real way. But these fungi farmers are hoping that more research on how to produce this delicious treat can help business.
We still have so much to learn about truffles.
Janine Davis is a plant scientist who works on a truffle testing orchard at North Carolina State University.
When we first started with the truffles, there wasn't a lot of information out there. People had no idea where to start looking. And a lot of people that get into truffles, they aren't farmers.
Non-biased information wasn't readily available to these people.
Inga Meadows works with Davis at NC State. She's a plant pathologist who fell into truffle research to help farmers.
At least I could provide some science-based information and hopefully counteract the misinformation. Because it's underground, we can't see it. And it requires a live host tree. You know, we can't grow it in culture in the lab like you can button mushrooms. It sounds simple, but makes it hard to know what's going on underneath that soil.
Back at Virginia Truffles, Chief Scientist Brandy Martin explains how they use science on the farm.
This is our full micro and molecular biology setup here that we have at Virginia Truffles. This is one of the only, if not the only, in-house testing facility on a truffle farm in the United States, which is really special, but also we find it very necessary to be able to do the science that protects our truffles.
Pinpointing the correct truffle DNA is crucial.
The reason that we test the DNA of truffles is because there are many different species of truffles. Some of them have a high culinary value, like ours. They smell and taste wonderful. Some of them do not.
They plant their crop by inoculating tree roots with truffle spores. Farmers need to know they're planting the valuable spores, hence the DNA testing. Virginia Truffles consultant Joe Porco explains.
So we'll grab a root sample, a nice like fluffy end root, look under there, and if we see these structures, that kind of hot dog looking structures on the tips of the roots, then it's a good way to know that your trees have been inoculated and you're well on your way to potentially producing truffle.
And Virginia Truffles can test truffle DNA for other growers to help the industry develop and work cooperatively rather than competitively.
I would like to see us be able to produce enough truffle across the country, all growers, that we can supply the demand. Like if I have a grower in Kentucky, I've got an order from a chef in Michigan, and I don't have enough truffle. Could you help me out by filling that order?
An order of American-grown truffles finding its way to a restaurant near you. For PBS News, I'm Casey Kuhn.